Integrating factors are a tool for solving first-order linear differential equations. Now, before I say anything specific about integrating factors, I'd like to introduce the idea through a couple of motivating examples. So let's start with this equation. Suppose that I want to solve x times y prime plus y equals cosine of x. Now, this doesn't look like an easy equation to solve. There's a cosine here and everything. But if you stare at it for a while, you may notice that the left-hand side has a special form. In fact, the left-hand side is a derivative. Applying the product rule to the product of x and y gives us x times y prime plus derivative of x, which is 1, times y. So the left-hand side of this equation is a derivative. Now, how would this help us actually solve the equation? Well, in fact, it helps us a lot. Using the fact that the left-hand side is a derivative, we just integrate both sides of x product xy prime equals cosine x, and we'll get x times y equals the integral of cosine x, which is sine x plus some constant. Now, I can solve for y. So I get y equals sine x plus c over x. So it's miraculous how easy it is to solve the equation once I notice that the left-hand side is a derivative. Now, it's not a bad idea for you to pause the video and to go back and to check that this actually is a solution to the original equation. Now, what's the idea of an integrating factor? Well, if I just gave you any old equation, most likely the left-hand side is not a derivative like it is in this situation. So the idea of an integrating factor is to multiply both sides of the equation by some factor, which we call the integrating factor, in order to make the left-hand side a derivative. Now, it may not be immediately obvious how we could do this, and I'll explain how we do it in general. But first, let me show you an example where we do this and we make the left-hand side a derivative. So let's start out with the equation y prime plus y equals 3. The left-hand side, if you stare at it for a while, you realize it doesn't look like a derivative. It's not like this guy up here, xy prime plus y. So what I'll do is I'll multiply by e to the x. If I multiply by e to the x, stare at it for a little bit, and you realize that indeed now the left-hand side is a derivative. It's the derivative of the product of e to the x and y. So now I have e to the x times y prime equals 3 e to the x. So I can continue with this process just like I did up here to solve for y. Now, why don't you do that and see what you get? So this is really all there is to it. This is the core idea of the technique of an integrating factor. Now there's one really big question that remains that I have not answered, and that is, where does this e to the x come from? How do I figure out what integrating factor to multiply by? And I will explain that next.